Greetings to one and all. I, Mr. Sambhajirao Suryavanshi, would like it very much to welcome one and all to the today's PowerPoint presentation on the topic Figures of Speech. I am extremely honored and privileged to start second part in the series on the topic Figures of Speech. In today's PowerPoint presentation, I am going to talk about 8 figures of speech: alliteration, hyperbole, onomatopoeia, paradox, climax, anticlimax, inversion, and euphemism. So, the very first figure of speech I am going to talk about today is alliteration. The repetition of the same letter or syllable at the beginning of two or more words is called as alliteration. For example, Adam ate apples and almonds in August. Second example, a load of learning lumbering in his head. And the third example, glittering through the gloomy glades. In the first example, letter or syllable A is repeated. In the second example, letter or syllable L, it is repeated. And in the third example, letter G, it is repeated. So let me say once again, when there is the repetition of the same letter or syllable at the beginning of two or more words, it is called alliteration. Next figure of speech is hyperbole. And the definition is, it is the use of exaggeration or overstatement for the purpose of emphasis or heightened effect. Then it is called as hyperbole. Example, here is the smell of blood, yet even all the perfumes of Arabia will not sweeten this little hand. Actually, to wash out the stains, we need water and soap or detergent powder. But here, Shakespeare is telling in the play Macbeth, when he committed the murder of King Duncan, he said, here is the smell of blood, yet even all the perfumes of Arabia will not sweeten this little hand. It is exaggeration. This is obviously overstatement, hyperbolic, and that's why to put emphasis and to heighten the effect, the words are used. Then it is called as hyperbole. And the second example, I shall bring millions of stars and the moon for you. If you are in the game of love, obviously to catch the attention of your lover, you always commit, give promises and talk too much. Here, lover is trying to convince his lover that I shall bring the millions of stars and the moon from the sky for you. This is nothing but exaggeration, hyperbole, or it is obviously overstatement, highly impossible. In practicality, it's obviously impossible. But it is the best example of hyperbole. Next figure of speech is onomatopoeia. In this figure of speech, the words convey the sound of the object or ideas expressed. When different animals are there, things are there, objects are there, to indicate the sound produced by animal or the thing or object, sound denoting words are used. See, for example, the clouds thundered all day long, murmur of innumerable bees, donkeys bray, dogs bark, birds twitter, snakes hiss, doves moan. Here, thundering of cloud, thunder, sound denoting word. When two or more clouds clash with each other, then the sound is produced. That one is called as thundering of clouds. Murmur of innumerable bees. When bees come together and they are in search of flowers, nectar, then the sound is produced, that is murmuring. This is sound denoting word, murmur. Again, braying, donkeys barking, dogs twittering, birds hissing, snakes moaning, doves. So braying, barking, twittering, hissing, moaning, these are the sound denoting words. When such sound denoting words are used, noticed in any line, then it is called as onomatopoeia. Next figure of speech is paradox. It is an apparently contradictory statement that nevertheless contains a measure of truth. For example, I am never at peace unless I am at war. And the second example is, art is a form of lying in order to tell the truth. Paradox means contradiction. Contradictory words are there. Contradictory words, contradictory terminologies, phraseologies, terms are used, then it is called as paradox. Here, at peace, at war, in the first example. In second example, lying and telling the truth. All these terminologies are contradictory, completely opposite to one another. That's why it is called as paradox. Next figure of speech is climax. It is an arrangement of a series of ideas in the order of increasing importance. See, for example, this is our life. Exempt from public haunt, finds tongues in trees, books in the running brooks, sermons in stones, and good in everything. Second example, I laugh, I sing, I dance for you. Here, in two examples, there is the arrangement of a series of ideas in the order of increasing importance. That's why it is called as climax. Anticlimax. Next figure of speech is anticlimax. This is the opposite to climax and signifies ludicrous descent from the higher to the lower. Then it is called as anticlimax. And the examples are, here I come, my country, my state and my city. Here I come, my country, my state, my city. Second example, I swear by the sun, by the moon and by the stars. In the first example, country, state and city. Higher to the lower. Arrangement of words as per the importance from higher to the lower level. Again, the sun, highest, moon, higher and stars, high. It means higher to the lower level arrangement of words is there. That's why it is called anticlimax. Now, inversion. Definition. It is the alteration of the normal word order to express extreme emotion. As a matter of fact, when you are at the deepest sorrow or when you are at the highest peak point of happiness, you cannot find words. You cannot catch proper words to express your extreme emotions. You struggle for want of words. And obviously, while dictating, while expressing your extreme emotions, your word order is changed. See, for example, 100 years did he live? As a matter of fact, the correct word order should be, he lived for 100 years. He lived for 100 years. But instead of telling, he lived for 100 years, he said, 100 years did he live? Second example, under this stone, he was buried. The actual word order is, he was buried under this stone. But in end part is taken to the front and the front part is taken to the end part. And that's why this kind of word order is there, then it is called as inversion. Metonymy. Definition is, metonymy is meant for a change of name. It is a substitute of the thing names for the thing it meant for. See, for example, the pen is mightier than sword. Second, from the cradle to the grave. And the third, I have never read John Milton. Here in the first example, pen and sword, two different things. But sword is a weapon, pen is also just like that of the weapon. So both are used to leave behind never forgetting impressions. But pen is mightier, more powerful than the sword. Second one is cradle to the grave. Cradle indicates childhood, grave indicates death. I have never read John Milton. Means what? I have never read books written by, books authored by John Milton. But instead of telling in clear words, it is said, I have never read John Milton. It is called as metonymy. And the last but not least, euphemism, a word or phrase used to avoid saying an unpleasant or offensive word is called as euphemism. See, for example, ultimately the great soul passed away. And the second example, he has fallen asleep. Passed away means dead. And passed asleep, fallen asleep means he is dead, permanently slept, never to get up again. But instead of using harsh word like dead, we use the soft words, that is passed away or fallen asleep. And such kind of terminology, when it is used to avoid harsh words, then it is called as euphemism. To conclude, today's PowerPoint presentation on the topic figures of speech, once again from the depth of my heart, I would like to make request to every one of you, please like my videos, share my videos, comment my videos, do subscribe my channel, and without fail, press the bell icon for my upcoming videos on education, motivation, spoken English, personality development, and much more. Till then, goodbye, take care, and God bless everyone.